Hello everyone, we are live again from Focus Hive, and today we are going to speak about really very interesting topic, you know, outside from our league of discussion. So we're going to talk today about the Falcon and the Winter Soldier. I know these series have been, you know, like immensely popular, and Marvel has just made it super interesting for all the Marvel fans. It is like an amazing show right now. I guess most of us have seen it, but today we are going to speak, and you know, we are going to discuss few important, you know, life lessons or few important points where we feel that we'll be talking about. And Ravi and me are very enthusiastic speaking about Steve Rogers and Sam Wilson.
And it's, I mean, Marvel has been a topic or a show that we have binge-watched so much. Give us a minute, something wrong with our speakers. Hope the voice is not echoing anymore. All right, perfect. Yeah, so what I was saying is Marvel has been something that we always keep watching, all the movies, all the shows, and with the recent show of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier has really captivated our minds, and our weekends has been very, very occupied by all the episodes that we had. Now, with that show, we were just having some discussion, and we thought, why not come in and ask some of the important questions that were kind of portrayed in that show, and then let's just discuss about those, right? I mean, you had characters like John Walker, Lemar, his friend. You had Sam Wilson, who eventually became the Captain America. And then we also have Bucky Barnes and how he battles through his own journey and all of that. And when we saw the movie Infinity War, at the end you saw Cap, right, the Captain America, giving the shield to Sam Wilson. And we all thought that probably the whole idea is to get the storyline towards making a colored Captain America, a serious tone to it. But when the show opens up, you eventually get to know that Sam did not take up that role. So let's kind of, me and Shivani will try and discuss about and throw some ideas around. Why was Sam chosen to become Captain America by Captain America himself? Right. That's so that's a very important question.
No, actually, I feel like, you know, Steve Rogers knew at that point of time, like, Sam is the only one who is, you know, going to take this forward. If you have seen all the movies, all the Avengers, and, you know, all different segments of the movies, Sam doesn't have any superpower. He is a normal human being. And you know, he is head-to-head with all the superheroes in the show. And let's not talk about Iron Man right now, because I'm focusing only on the Winter Soldier. But, you know, Rogers knew. Sam is the one who can do it. Why he didn't choose Bucky, though he was his very good friend? I feel, Ravi, at that point of time, Bucky was also growing up, you know, becoming a white wolf, and, you know, he had his own inner turmoils to settle in. Because if you see the first Captain America, when he fell in that valley, he was directly seen in the Winter Soldier movie, with his iron arm, and, you know, he was already traumatized by Russians. So I think he had his own battles to settle right now. And, you know, with this, I say it is always very important to take some time out for yourself. You need time to heal. You need that time for yourself. And I think that what's Bucky did. And that's what Steve Rogers knew. And he wanted him to be on that way. And he wanted him to discover himself and you know, to move on that path. So that's why Sam Wilson was chosen. But Bucky.
Very good point that you've raised, that Bucky had his own journey to complete and his inner turmoil that he was fighting. He had to become one with it. And I mean, that's one very deep meaning to it, and probably Cap knew about that. Now, Cap was a super soldier. He took the serum. And we all know that Bucky was also given a serum when he was captured by Hydra. And he was also a super soldier. And the pain and the agony that Captain America, Steve Rogers, went through seeing his loved ones go away one by one while he was still alive, or maybe when he came back after 17 years, he couldn't find anyone that he knew at his age when he was in his prime or when he was growing up. So when he came back, when he was defrosted and when he came back to life after 17 years, the world was changed. That in itself gives a lot of pain and shock to you. So Cap or Steve went through all of this himself, and still he carried the burden, you may say, of becoming the Captain America and being that number one soldier, number one leader for Avengers. And he knew Bucky is also a super soldier giving, and he already carries some kind of burden with him from his past where he has done mistakes, wrongdoings. He has to be one with it. So let's let him first do that. And then probably if time comes, he can pick up the shield. But that was never shown or discussed. And I believe Steve Rogers understood it. And he wanted Bucky to be free from all this Captain America burden. But at the same time, you also brought a very good point that Sam was toe-to-toe with every Avenger, even though he was not a super soldier. He never took the serum. He never got the opportunity to take the serum on the first place. But
we know we should never forget about John Walker also. This show, we saw another Cap, John Walker, and he was also extremely qualified. You know, he won so many medals and he have been in the army. And, you know, I think he could have been a captain, but the acceptance was not there for him because Steve Rogers have really set the bar high. Even I was personally not liking John Walker as captain because, you know, with this, I say everything takes time. And, you know, John Walker didn't get that support. He was not understood. He has that one friend of his who was by his side, you know, talking to him, taking care of him. And that friend was also, you know, murdered by the fighters, like who were struggling for their, for their, you know, freedom. And that was the time we saw that anger in John Walker as well. And it was like, you know, that scene was epic, Ravi. If you see the moment, the direction of that, the chill with blood, and you know, you see that it was like heart-shattering. And you know, I think at some point of time Bucky's anger for Sam was justified, but they were enemies, and you know, they end up being friends in this show. So that's the journey they also took. So they tried and they understood each other. So Sam understood Bucky's point of view. So, you know, initially when Bucky was going to the therapist, and the therapist used to tell him, you have to, you know, speak, you have to. So it's very important to be vocal, you know. People will not understand on their own, like what you are going through, what is the turmoil, you have to speak through. So, you know, once said, if you do not feel something is right or you are feeling bad about it, keep it out and open. This thing you did, I didn't like it, and this is how I felt. So that is how it should be. And that is what Bucky did with Sam. And then Sam opened up. Like, you know, that is why I let go of that shield. And you know, because Black... Now I have to bring in Isaiah also in this. You know, it is all so super linked. I have to bring in Isaiah also in this, who was the first Black Captain America. You know, that's why, you know, I really like the series, because it has gone so in depth of this, because I never knew, you know, I've never read the comics, but, you know, I have seen all the movies, but we have never seen, like, even Isaiah was mentioned in any of the movie. And how hard it was for him. But at the end of the show, when you see Sam Wilson in that and he says, I am Captain America. That was like, you know, I think the most elated moment in that show. So sometimes it's important to open up, tell, you know, what you are feeling is not right. And it's always okay, you know, to tell someone that feel you are feeling. So that's what Bucky did with Sam. And it was amazing. It was amazing. And I see them as friends now.
It was absolutely amazing. And I would like to again come back to the question that we had as to why was Sam chosen to be the Captain America. And looking at the whole journey, right, that towards the end, we are super convinced. And when he, as you said, right, when he comes back and says, I am Captain America, and that's like super elated moment, and it's highly satisfying, right? Like, you did it, my boy. That's the kind of moment it was. And the whole show is built around Sam's journey, Sam's life, how he sees through the struggle, and a lot of other areas were touched as well, which is currently going on within America, which is more about color and all that. We'll not get into that. But overall, a great journey shown for Sam. But again, we saw this decision by Cap, even the whole six episode, before these six episode in the end of the movie, right? And that's Cap. Cap already knew. I mean, Steve Rogers already knew he is the guy, right? Because if you watch The Winter Soldier, wherein the first scene cuts in and you see Cap running with Sam and they become friends. And then when Steve Rogers was in trouble due to Project Insight, and then he reaches out to Sam for help. And then that's when Sam kind of goes in and tells that, okay, fine, I will be part of your team and will help you fight and help you bring down the Project Insight and the whole game of S.H.I.E.L.D. And that whole movie goes in and it builds on the character of Falcon and at the same time introduces that Winter Soldier in that movie. But it clearly shows that Sam Wilson, who was not a super soldier, who was a normal human being, yes, so well-trained military operatives with great gadgets that at his disposal, the Falcon wing and then the weapon that he had, with that he was equivalent to any other superhero that we had, and he carried that with a lot of respect, honor and responsibility. He did not go rogue with that. And if you look at the Civil War movie, in that also he fought for the right values alongside Steve Rogers. So all of that builds into the character, and you agree to what Steve Rogers did. He selected Sam Wilson as to be Captain America. And that leads us to the second question, which is when the Falcon and Winter Soldier show starts, you get to see that Sam is not Captain America, which we all thought that Sam will be Captain America. And the show would be as if Captain America and Winter Soldier are fighting, doing the battle. But the when the show opens up, you are in surprise and you realize that Sam Wilson is not Captain America and he has given up the shield. And just like Bucky was upset, even I was upset. I think a lot of fans, every other fan was not happy about it, that why did Sam give up the shield? And that's the very question that we want to figure out now in this.
No. So, Ravi, Sam was also under a lot of pressure, if you see. So, Steve Rogers had name. He was an epitome of, you know, loyalty. He was epitome of trustworthiness and, you know, righteous. He was righteous. And Sam had that responsibility because being Captain America, you know, a lot of responsibility on his shoulders. And Sam may have thought somewhere in his heart, like, he might not be right for that because Steve set the, you know, bars really high and Sam was, you know, gone by that Thanos. and yeah, so Sam was, you know, missing for 5 years and he come back. He has battles of his family, and that responsibility that Steve gave to him. He thought he might not be worthy of it. Maybe someone else, could be more worthy, and he wanted to give that opportunity. I feel he was being humble, and he thought like maybe he would not put up that great work. So I think he was in self-doubt. But, he needed Bucky to make him realize that Steve saw something in you. That's why you got it. And you have to pull it through. You have to do it. So that nudge is always there. And it happens in real life as well. If you are going to do something and you will be like, nah, I can't do it. I don't think so. I will be able to do it. You need someone to poke you, because you won't know that you are good. And sometimes you think also that I might be good, but I might not be that good. So you need that person in your life who knows you in and out to give you that nudge. Maybe Bucky was his foe, but he wanted him to be that, because he trusted his friendship with Steve. They both were like great friends. And Steve was like, okay, Sam, you do it. And Bucky was angry with Sam, like, why? If Steve thought something about you, he might have seen something in you. That is why he gave it to you. So he had to overcome that self-doubt that he was in. And when he took the reins into his hand and, he started working on it, and we were like, wow, this is what we wanted to see in the first episode. And, it was a highly amazing moment. And yeah, I think
what you've said, that it was a big task to carry, right? And he was probably in doubt, or probably he needed a little bit of nudge, which was done by Bucky. But, I want to bring up a concept that I have written it in one of the articles that I've posted about transitioning to a manager from an individual contributor. And that is basically a imposter syndrome. Right, when somebody gets or achieves something very quickly, right, they suddenly start feeling that, was I entitled for it? Was I supposed to get this benefit? Was I supposed to get this title? Am I good enough for it? And if you don't go through the journey of discovery, right, if you don't discover yourself, and if you don't figure out whether you are really suitable for the task given or the task that you've taken up, either ways, then that imposter syndrome kind of plays a lot in your mind, and then probably you will not be able to deliver the goods that you're supposed to. And for me, that was the key for Sam to not take it. Because Sam knew Steve Rogers was, as you've said, epitome of self-righteousness. Right? He was the best specimen of human being. Right? He was, he had America's ass, right? So So you have to fill that shoe. You're not a super soldier. You have self-doubt a little bit that whether you will be able to be as good as Steve. So when you have those self-doubt, it's way better to go discover yourself, figure out your pro and cons, tackle those doubts, correct all of those, and then come and take up the challenge. However, it was a show, it was a movie, and nothing waits, right? Nothing waits for anyone. And I think that this pretty much covers as to why Sam did not take up the shield. And then later on, he had to, because, he went through the journey and he happened to realize that if not me, then who? Right? The moment you have that realization, that pretty much tells you that you have that leadership quality. You have to step up, take it, take the responsibility, drive it, get it, happen, right? Make it happen. That is what your responsibility is as a leader, to show everybody how it's done. Show the path, show the goal, show how it can be done, and all of that, right? The moment you have that clarity, that vision in your mind, you will be able to do it, or you will be able to drive your workforce to do that. So the moment Sam realized that, with the journey in the 5 episodes that he had, and then he started training for it, and he became Captain America after that. And that is where I wanted to also ask the third and the last question that we have for today, which was about John Walker. We never knew about who this guy was, right? You might have 10 other people in army who were equally good. Maybe authorities did not know about him. Or, I mean, this is something just I'm making up, right? But let's say John Walker was the number one soldier in US Army. And he was showing all the characteristics of Steve Rogers. He was whatever it takes to be that guy, right?
But what was the hurry?
Okay. There was no hurry to fill the shoes of Steve Rogers. No. But authorities, government wanted a poster boy, right? They felt a void, and they wanted a poster boy, and that's where they chose somewhat similar guy to do the job.
But you see, even John Walker was, as I spoke earlier also, John Walker was also under so much of pressure, because he was also equally good. If you see, you have seen the cameo where he was, you know, fighting. He had that strength. He had that strength. But, you know, he was drowned in that burden so much because he was not able to prove his worth. He was not able to be friends with Bucky or Sam because they never thought him to be part of their gang. And at a point, I can say it is bad for Walker as well. If he would have been welcomed by them, I think so he might not end up being an agent, if you see in the last episode, because he was like, you know, thrown away from every other place. You know, he was trying to be, he wanted to be friends with Falcon and Winter Soldier. He didn't have any luck. He loved his partner so much, he was killed. Then he was being tried at the court, and you know, instead of understanding what he's going through and putting him in rehab, you know, they throw him out. And at that time, he was like, forget it. I don't want to do it. And then, you know, then you resort to things which you do not want to do. And then you will be like, you know, what is this for? What I'm doing it for? There's nothing that I'm getting out of. So what is it for me? Walker didn't get anything. And, you know, he took that serum. If you see, he took that serum, you know, in order to avenge his friend's death. And he went on a path. He went astray. And no one understood him. Even as a viewer, if I say, I started developing, you know, sorry feelings for him. Like, maybe if he would have been a part of the clan, maybe he could have been, you know, a better Captain America. But you know, it was Sam. Sam has to be there. I think when the second season comes up, we see Walker as a US agent, and I don't know like how it will turn out. And I'm really looking forward to that. Let's see.
Yeah, I think I don't agree to one point that you had wherein you say that Walker tried to be friends with Sam and Bucky, but Bucky and Sam pushed him away. Well, let's understand. Bucky and Sam are part of Avengers. Okay? They are the elite of the elite. In order to be that in that group, you have to earn it. You can't be someone appointed in that position, right? Tomorrow, you cannot government or president of United States of America or president of India or president of any other country for that matter comes and says, okay, this guy is Hulk. Will you buy that? Exactly. So that is what had happened. And I mean, Bucky, being a super soldier, he knows what it takes to be Cap America. Sam knows and had been with Steve, and the position that he saw, the shield, the value that shield carried was of immense caliber and immense respect, which is why he did not take it himself, right? He was also equally good. And that's when they both are little upset with Walker as to how can you take it, dude? I mean, who are you? That's their behavior. Kon hai bhai tum? That's a very simple question they had. And all of a sudden he comes, I'm Captain America. Hello. And I'm like, Nikal, sidele. That's the whole attitude that Bucky and Sam had. right? Now, that's truth. That's how it has to be. That's how it will be. I mean, there's no two way about it. But looking at it from the perspective of John Walker, he thinks he did everything that he could have to be in the position that he was in. And he thought whatever he got it because of his caliber, his character, his strength, his all good things that he did. But I feel, again, that government was in too much of a hurry to find another poster boy to showcase as Captain America, a symbol kind of a character, and they appointed this guy. And at the hint of first problem, they fired him. Right? Captain America is not a toy. Captain America role is not a toy. You cannot just hire someone, say you are Captain America, one mistake, go tada bye. That is what was wrong in that whole show. Yes, the values Captain America stood with was all shattered the moment John Walker killed that guy. Now, but why did he kill that person? I mean, the member of HAND. Why did he kill him? Because that guy had killed Lamar, his best friend, his Bucky, right? Like Steve Rogers has Bucky Barnes, John Walker had Lamar. They both were equally close. So if somebody kills Lamar, John Walker has to go mad. And that's why he kind of went rogue. But he was not a bad guy. If he were a bad guy, he would have not saved that falling bus. He threw the shield and he saved that bus, which clearly shows that he is a good guy at heart. And which is why at the end, you see him transition into US agent with a black dress. And probably in the next season or next movie, he would come up with some great work that he could do for himself. So with that, I think these characters have shown great journey for themselves. The whole show was amazing. And there are a lot of learnings that we could also have from each of these characters, each of the episodes that were played. And something that I learned from Sam was exactly the the syndrome that I spoke about, right? The imposter syndrome. And it is something that I wrote in the article as well. I mean, this is very critical for everybody to understand that you get what you get for what you have done, right? Don't have that imposter syndrome within you, whether you are good enough for doing it. If you need time, take your time, understand, and be one with your challenges. But you've got what you've got because what you've done. With that, I want to rest my case. And if there are any questions, any clarification from anyone in the listeners, then they can ask us.
Right. And I want to sum up this conversation where I just want to point out a few things. Like, always lead with empathy. Lead with kindness. And, you know, you're more than, you know, your mistakes. Because mistakes are bound to happen. You are to learn from them. And don't forget to invest in good friendships that will go on forever. And, you know, take time for yourself. Take time to heal. That is very essential. With this, we sign off. Bye-bye. We'll come back next week with some interesting topic for you all. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.